Hello, everyone. You're watching Over Under. I had to do it again. Sorry. Here on KTV2, my name is Hussein Jawahri, and this is your show where we talk about movies, TV shows, and video games. And today I'm joined by a special guest, a fellow host on KTV2 and KTV1, joined by Quamar, aka Mooney. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Hussein, for having me on your show. It's been such an exciting journey to be part of the KTV family with you guys.
And that's what I want to ask you at first. Like, how's it been? Like, you're doing two shows, if I believe. Like, there's a show on KTV1 called Virtual Reality.
Yes,
and a show on KTV2 called, I don't want to forget and say the wrong name because I was saying the wrong name before we started.
Afternoon tea. Yes, sir. It's so the close. Afternoon tea.
Okay, tell me about those shows, please.
All right, awesome. So the cool thing is that one of the shows is in Arabic and the other is in English.
Okay.
And the Arabic show is the one that's all about movies and anime and gaming. And it's actually a very new show. So excited to have you guys on and also to have you guys maybe co-host an episode with us.
I would love that.
We'd really love that. To have you. And then also the English show, the Afternoon Tea, is where we host and get to interview different people within the society, whether they're athletes, scientists. We even had somebody who was an astronaut in training.
Wow.
And we get to interview them and just kind of just show our pride and joy of the people that are locals here in Kuwait.
Well, that's really wonderful. Well, now here we're doing something similar to what you do on your show on KTV1, where we discuss mostly pop culture when it comes to like movies, TV shows, and video games. But here we have buzzers. We have two buzzers.
I noticed.
Red and green. And for our first time viewers, we use these buzzers to talk about the movie and we decide if they're overrated or underrated. And we picked a franchise today, a really exciting franchise to talk about. We can also see if that franchise holds up till this day. We can discuss if people would watch it or not. And that's a question that I normally ask to my co-host, AJ, when he's here. So I would ask you the same. So right now, to people who have not seen Men in Black, all of them, like even the spinoff that happened with Chris, like from part one, part three, and edition one, using these two buzzers, would you recommend people to watch this franchise in 3, 2, 1?
We work for a highly funded yet unofficial government agency.
We'll take it from here.
Who the hell are you?
INS Division 6.
There is no Division 6.
Our mission is to monitor extraterrestrial activity on Earth.
You're all here because you're the best of the best, and we're looking for one of you.
Hey! What's up?
I want to get some coffee. You want some coffee?
No, thank you. I'm fine.
Hey, there, folks.
Hey.
You guys get along all right?
No.
All right, I'm in.
From now on, you will have no identifying marks of any kind. You are no longer part of the system. We are the Men in Black.
You know what the difference is between you and me? I make this look good.
Men in Black. Protecting the Earth from the scum of the universe.
You know how to use these things?
No idea whatsoever.
Yes, sir, I would recommend.
Okay, now I need to tell me why. So this is like, we have four movies. Mm-hmm. Now you're telling people to watch. Why should they watch Men in Black?
See, I'll put a disclaimer over here. I am recommending you guys watch the first two. Three and four seem to be an optional choice.
Okay, but I think when people get hooked, and I've mentioned that before on the show, like when you watch the first part of any movie and you really enjoy it, even sometimes when the sequels are not that good, you're like, you really want to watch it because I want to know what happens. I want to see the story. I want to see what happens to the character.
Absolutely. Like, it's the world itself. Like, the Men in Black created a universe. You know, yeah. What it has aliens. It has the FBI. It has Will Smith.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So they created a world where you do indulge in it. You do want to find out more. And the humor there is impeccable. So I do understand, definitely, once you've committed to a franchise, you kind of do want to know what happens next.
Yeah, and I believe with Men in Black, what they did, we've seen aliens in a lot of movies, mm-hmm. but we haven't seen them portrayed in the way they did it in Men in Black because it was done in a really fun way. The aliens looked really fun. They're part of society while people don't even know it. And you had this like really comedic genius, as I would call Will Smith, along
Absolutely.
With Tommy Lee Jones. And when you put someone who's extremely hilarious and definitely not serious when it comes to portraying, you know, the role of the he was playing in the movie and putting him against someone that's like super serious, that's pure comedy.
That dynamic, like their dynamic together was insane. Like they complimented each other with just, like you said, how opposite they actively were.
Yeah.
And then even the dynamic that they had as like the men in black with the aliens themselves, like it was kind of funny because they're trying to capture aliens and protect Earth. But then there are some aliens that have like better connections with the men in black and they work for the men in black. So it was just such a cool, intricate film.
Absolutely. And the villain in part one, someone every time I remember is like, he's truly disgusting.
Oh my God. I just remember right? The cockroaches.
The giant one. And he's like, I don't know, his face, his skin, the way he walks. And they said that the actor wore something on his legs so he can walk the way he was walking in that movie. And it's just really exciting. And you remember even the dog in the movie when they were interrogating the little dog?
Was it a pug?
Yeah.
I have a little pug Funko Pop. I was supposed to bring my Funkos today for the Men in Black. And one of them is actually the little pug.
And I mean, the scenes, they have a lot of iconic scenes. And it's really beautiful. The weapons are really, I love the weapons in Men in Black. When they open that scene and you see all these weapons appear.
Absolutely.
It's absolutely like, I would, you know, and the funny part is when he, all those huge guns and he end up having that little tiny gun for like Will Smith. Like I said, that these two working together were absolutely amazing. Now, the first one got released and it was a huge, huge hit. And then we got introduced to the sequel, which was a little bit. I mean, I know you talk, you know, about part two was that I forgot her name. The one with the black hair. AJ, help us.
Help us out. Was she the one that ends up getting with Will Smith or something?
Kind of like, I think she's the one with the tentacles, what they call them.
Interesting.
Or was that three? That was two. Two was bad, Mooney. It was really bad.
Yeah.
I don't know why we recommend like two. Two was
right. I thought, you know, like, but then, you know, three and four came along and like the standards.
Yeah.
But it's all right.
Serlina. Yes, okay. Didn't like that character at all. Didn't pose a threat to me in that movie. I wasn't really engaged in that story per se, like how they were like the storytelling. Again, comedy was there.
Comedy, it's a dynamic.
Yeah, Will Smith and Tommy Lee Jones. And then we got the third one, which is a complete blur to me.
I don't remember it.
Was it the one with the one? The time travel. So that was an interesting one. I think it wasn't as exciting, of course, as the first one, but the story in that one was really good.
I'm sure the story itself, like you said, going back in time and getting to see like a young, you know,
his like his story with his dad, I think was the emotional part that kind of gave that Men in Black 3 that drama aspect that was kind of missing out in the second one. I mean, the first one I would understand because they were telling the story of Tommy Lee Jones quitting at the end, and that was like kind of dramatic and it was sad. But the third one definitely told a very interesting story when it comes to the background of Will Smith's character with his father. And that was really interesting. And then we got International. I think that movie shouldn't have been released.
Yeah, like I feel like honestly it's a thing that a lot of like the, you know, Hollywood I guess is doing right now where they kind of milk a successful franchise. Yes.
They're doing another fifth Men in Black.
Okay. Oh, there's a fifth one in the works.
Yeah.
Is it with the same character from like the I think it was the fourth one with the girl that goes into the MIB and then
the International.
Yeah, so now is it they're going to be part 2 of the same characters, do you think? Will Smith
they might do a crossover between
one.
Both.
I'd like that. That would be a lot of because I honestly, if we can get the old dynamic or like a touch of it, like Will Smith, but then in the new film.
I mean, if you're saying Will Smith, Chris Hemsworth in the same movie, I would definitely watch
Will
that.
Will Smith and a Hemsworth. I am 100% down for that.
Okay, let me just quickly play a game with you called Over Under, which is the name of our show. I'm gonna check the ratings for each movie, and I want to see if you agree or disagree with the ratings using the buzzers in front of you.
Sure.
Okay, let's start with you're enjoying the buzzers, aren't you?
I love the buzzers. I've been buzzing since before we've been live, guys.
Okay, okay, here we go. Men in Black, the first one, released in 1997, got a rating of 71%. Agree or disagree?
Oh my god, see, like, I'm gonna, like, just so you know, like, relatively, I'm not on like an Oscars grading level right now.
Okay.
So no,
this
a
is
70
like the fans
something.
Level.
This yeah, fans level. Like fans level, you know what? 70, I could do with a 70.
I agree.
Right?
I agree.
70's fine, it's fair.
Great for Men in Black, especially nowadays if people want to see because the CGI doesn't hold up as it used to back in the
That's
day.
True.
So yeah, okay. Men in Black 2 released 2002, got a rating of 49%.
Okay, I don't think it was that bad. Was it that bad, guys? You think you'd agree?
Yes. My buzzer stopped working.
Okay. It's shocked like I am. Okay, I'm going to have to disagree. I don't think it's like a 4 point something.
It was. There was these like little creatures I remember now that were really funny in part 2, but I think lacked story-wise and the villain was bad.
That's
okay.
True.
Men in Black 3, released in 2012, got a rating of 58. Oof.
Okay. Well, I forgot about that one. Yeah. So I'm going to agree that it's a 50-50 that.
I mean... Yeah, I was going to put it to 60, but okay. And then we have the last one, Men in Black International has a rating of, which doesn't show
curious.
On my phone.
I'm so curious in comparison to the last few, because last few came out along.
38.
38? Okay, I know that it's not even working. Here, you want to use the buzzer? Go for it, because I'm going to, it's not that bad. 38?
38.
That's not that bad.
For a movie that you can't remember at all?
No, but see, I remember the fourth one. I remember there was a girl there. I remember there was a Hemsworth there. But, like, I did not remember the third one.
But, yeah, okay. I so, you know, we agreed and disagreed in some of them, which is okay. We're now just going to take a quick break and come back and do a segment called What You Don't Know. We'll be right back. And we're back from our very short break here on Over Under, talking about the franchise Men in Black with Mooney. We both agreed that you should watch the franchise, but we agreed and disagreed about some of the ratings in the movies. Now we're doing a segment called What You Don't Know, which is facts about Men in Black that you probably didn't know. Ooh. Okay, let's start with the first one. Let me zoom in because I'm old and I can barely read. Okay. The crew blew up a 25-gallon drum of blue slime for the first scene in the beginning of the movie. I remember that one. That was a really funny scene. 25-gallon. Wow.
Of what?
Of blue slime. Remember
of blue
when they,
slime.
Yeah, when they blew up
oh
that
Oh, my God.
Alien
yes, I like remember. How many gallons?
25.
25 gallons of blue slime?
That's a lot.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
That's a lot.
Okay, the second fact that we have, according to Tommy Lee Jones, he didn't mind being covered in slime, but Will Smith hated it. You can actually see it in his face in some scenes when he gets the slime on him. That's
oh,
actually
poor man.
True.
It is a fantastic franchise. And plus, like, how many years ago since it came out?
Yeah.
Like, I don't think the human brain can even, like, hold on to that many movies anymore.
Yeah. But still, I mean, Men in Black is still one of those movies. If I'm just, like, walking by and I see it, like, on TV, I would just, like, sit down and just watch a little 100%. Bit. And, yeah, it's one of the great, I think, roles for Will Smith, which is Men in Black. Unfortunately, this is all the time that we have for our show. Mooney, thank you again for joining me. We'd definitely love to have you again here on the show and discuss some skateboard games.
Definitely. Yeah. It's been so much fun, guys. I've loved being in the studio with you and definitely looking forward to our next episode together.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate it. Thank you all for watching. This was Over Under, Saint Joaquin on the mic. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.